Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, my name is Muhammad Arif Nur Hadi. I'm from MTS Science Algebra. In here, I want to tell you a story about Sangkuriang. Let's begin. In ancient time, there is a princess in West Java named Dayang Sumbi. She had a son named Sangkuriang. Sangkuriang was a boy who liked to hunt. And when hunting, he was always accompanied by his dog named Tumang. Despite a dog, Tumang was actually an incarnation of the god and the father of Sangkuriang. One day, he got mad at Tumang for not pursuing the animals. Because of so angry, he then expelled Tumang, so the dog went into the woods. He then returned to the palace and told the incident to his mother. What happened, my son? Where's Tumang? I expelled him because he's not listening to me. Dayang Sumbi was so angry and hit his head. Sangkuriang then disappointed and he decided to wander. After hitting Sangkuriang, Dayang Sumbi felt so sorry and she always prayed and meditated to get forgiveness from God. Oh God, please forgive me. I didn't mean to hurt my son. One day, the god gave a gift because she was so diligent in praying. The prize is a timeless beauty that will make Dayang Sumbi becoming young forever. After wandering for a dozen years, Sangkuriang returned home. When he reached the kingdom, all had changed. He didn't know what was happening. One day, he met a girl who was so beautiful. The girl was actually Dayang Sumbi, his own mother. Sangkuriang fell in love with the girl and then proposed her. "Will you marry me?" Because of the handsomeness that was owned by Sangkuriang, then Dayang Sumbi also fell in love. "Yes, I do." One day, Sangkuriang want to hunt, and he asked Dayang Sumbi to fix the headband. However, Dayang Sumbi surprised that her future husband had a head injury. "What happened with your head?" "It's because my mom, she hit me." Dayang Sumbi then realized that was the same injury as her son who wandered away. After those happenings, she immediately looked for ways to thwart the plan of making a proposal. "If you want to marry me, first, you should stem the Citarum River. Secondly, you have to make a big canoe to cross the river. And both of those conditions should be finished before sunrise. Can you do that for me?" "Of course I can." At night, Sangkuriang asked for help to spirit creatures to complete all the work. Dayang Sumbi secretly peeked at the job. Once the work was almost complete, Dayang Sumbi ordered her forces to hold a very long red carpet to the east of the city. The carpet met light became red and Sangkuriang thought the sun had risen. "No, this can't be happening. I'm not even done." He stopped his work and was very upset because all could not meet the requirement posed by Dayang Sumbi. Using his strength, he broke the dam and the city became flooding. His big canoe then crashed upside down and changed into a mountain named Tangkuban Perahu. The moral value of this story is, don't let your anger control you. Thank you for your attentions. Create your own creativity beyond the normal limit. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.